The goal-seek function in Excel is a finance person's secret weapon, and I will help you understand how to use it. Have you ever been in one of those grueling budgeting or forecasting sessions where you have endless discussions about things like revenue and headcount? Usually, the finance person is the one picking up the pieces after the meeting to make sure everything is correctly reflected in the spreadsheets. Here's one such spreadsheet, the cash flow forecast spreadsheet. The months are at the top here, then the opening cash balance by month, various types of cash movements, inflows and outflows during the month, and the expected cash ending balance down here. Now you've probably noticed the number in red for June, a negative cash balance. That's not supposed to happen. That number needs to be at least zero. You bring it up to your manager, who responds, just plug it, or just fix the spreadsheet. That's where you take out the secret weapon called GoalSeek. It's a tool that gives you the ability to calculate backward to obtain an input that would result in a given output. Let's see how GoalSeek works. Cell G23 is the one that needs to be fixed. There's a formula in there. By double-clicking on the cell, we see that G23 is the sum of four other cells. The opening balance in cell G2 plus or minus the total of the cash from operating, investing, and financing activities. If you want to make that even more visual, then go to Formulas, Trace Precedents. Let's see what's going on in one of those precedents, G10. It's a sum of the movements above in G5 through G9. Most of those cells contain negative numbers. How about we plug some more positivity into G5? Which will work its way into G10, and then fix our red cell, G23. Let's go back to G23, go to the Data tab, What If Analysis on the far right, GoalSeek. Find the right input for the value you want. Sounds like a plan. Click on GoalSeek, and out pops a dialog box. Set cell G23 to value 0 by changing cell G5. Ready? Go. Alas, that doesn't work. We get an error message, cell must contain a value. Let's click OK to that error message, and then cancel the GoalSeek operation, and figure out what is going on in G5. There's a formula in there, not a value. The formula simply links to G31, the expected collections in the month of June. This cell, in turn, links to F29, the expected revenue in May. F29 is the product of multiplying the expected revenue for the year in B27 by the percentage of the total year revenue allocated to May in cell F28. We could use GoalSeek on cell F28 as the input cell. What if GoalSeek set cell G23 to value 0 by changing cell F28? Okay, that fixes our cash balance problem. Well, we now have errors in cells N28 and N29. The sum of the revenue split over the months is bigger than the annual revenue. This we can also fix using GoalSeek, as N28, the target variable, also has a formula, which is a requirement for GoalSeek to work. Set N28 to 100% by changing G28. GoalSeek works with absolute numbers in the value field, as well as with percentages. GoalSeek only works on one-to-one relationships between cells. It cannot handle one-to-many or many-to-one. If we don't want to adjust the monthly split of the revenue, then click Undo twice and put a plug into cell B27, the expected revenue for the year. You could start typing various numbers into that cell directly, like 850,000 or 820,000, using trial and error, and see if that fixes G23, the ending cash balance in June. But it's much easier to have Excel do the calculating for you by using our GoalSeek secret weapon. Excel GoalSeek performs all calculations for you behind the scenes. GoalSeek doesn't change the formulas, it uses the existing formulas. What if analysis, GoalSeek, set cell G23 to 0 by changing cell B27, OK. GoalSeek found a solution for you. Instead of the value of $800,000 in revenue that was in B27 before, there's now $827,000 in there. If you think that's a reasonable estimate for the year, then click OK to accept. If you think that's a completely outrageous number, then hit Cancel to indicate you don't accept the solution. If you hit OK, then GoalSeek overrides the previous data. If you do change your mind, there's always the undo button to save you. You don't necessarily have to change revenue. You could decide to plug a number elsewhere to make your negative expected cash balance in G23 go away. How about experimenting with the headcount plan? There's hiring going on in April. Headcount increases from 8 in cell D34 to 9 in cell E34. Let's see what happens if we use the GoalSeek secret weapon to change E34. What if analysis? GoalSeek set cell G23 to 0 by changing cell E34. This shows that Excel can help you with the calculation, but not with the thinking. There's a difference between spreadsheet reality and business reality. Would it make sense to you to fire someone in April, headcount going from 8 to 7, and then hire two people in May, headcount going from 7 to 9? Nah, not really. Secret weapons like GoalSeek can be very dangerous if they are in the wrong hands. GoalSeek doesn't evaluate for you whether the cells you choose to include have any logical relationship. I could take the very silly step of trying to set G23, the cash ending balance in June, to 0 by changing cell M19, debt repayment in December. GoalSeek doesn't question whether that is remotely logical, it just does as it is told. When you click OK, you see that Excel is running many iterations of GoalSeek and concluding after a while that it may not have found a solution. If you make the mistake of clicking OK, accepting the latest iteration, GoalSeek overrides the previous number in cell M19 with a nonsensical number. What we learn from this is that GoalSeek is sometimes not able to find a solution because that solution simply does not exist. Just like the input cell must contain the value, the output cell must contain the formula. If we want to set cell B30 to 50,000 by changing cell B27, then GoalSeek cannot do as it is told, as B30 does not contain a formula. Use GoalSeek to find the result you want by adjusting an input value. If you know the result that you want from a formula, but are not sure what input value the formula needs to get that result, use the GoalSeek feature.